Welcome back to video 2 of stage 2 of this demo series. We're going to continue immediately from the end of video 1, so let's get started. Now at this point we need to extract some important configuration items out of the connection config documents that we downloaded earlier in this stage of the demo. So we should have two documents, one for the first connection and one for the second. So all I've done on this screen right now is on the right, I've opened connection1config.txt, and then on the left, I've opened the demo value template file that's also attached to this lesson. So this is a template document that I've created, which hopefully will make it easier for you to note down all of these important values. So let's get started populating all of the values that we need. So structurally, we're extracting values from two different VPN connections. The first connection is stored in connection1 config. The second connection is stored in connection2 config. So inside this template, you have space for both connection1, which is here, and connection2, which is here. Now, in addition to that, there are a number of shared values which apply to both of the connections. So the first thing that we need to obtain is the router1 private IP and the router2 private IP for our simulated on-premises environments. So to do that, move back to the AWS console, go to the CloudFormation console, select the one-click deployment stack, and then click on the Outputs tab. And as outputs, I've configured this template to show you the private IP addresses for router1 and router2. So first, copy the private IP address for router1 into your clipboard and paste that on the top line. Go back to the console and do the same for the router2 private IP address. Make sure that you do note down the private address, not the public, and then paste that in right below it. Now these two BGP ASNs, we'll be using these later in the demo series, but these are going to be constant, so I've pre-populated those in the template. Now let's start with connection1. So this is the connection between AWS and the on-premises router1. So for connection1, there are two different tunnels, the one on the top and the one on the bottom. Now this configuration document is also split into two main sections. We've got IPsec Tunnel 1, and then if we scroll down toward the bottom of the file, we've got IPsec Tunnel 2. So all of this configuration information is duplicated in this document. The top is for Tunnel 1, and the bottom is for Tunnel 2. So make sure that you're looking at the document for Connection 1, because if we make any mistakes at this stage, it will prevent the rest of the demo from working. Now, if you prefer to extract all of the information yourself, toward the bottom of this template file are instructions on how you can extract all of these important values. So you can either watch the rest of this video, or you can finish this video and do the extraction on your own, manually using these instructions. But just to make it easier, each of these tunnels will require a pre-shared key. So you can see the pre-shared key. Let's go to Tunnel 1. So this is IPsec Tunnel 1. And then under Internet Key Exchange Configuration, you'll see a heading called Pre-Shared Key, and you'll need to copy that entire value. Make sure you don't miss any of the characters. Copy that into your clipboard and paste it into the line for Connection 1 Tunnel 1 Pre-Shared Key. Now to get the next information, so on-prem outside IP, just make sure that you're still in the IPsec Tunnel 1 part and just scroll down. Look for the tunnel interface configuration, and this is the one toward the top part of this document. Remember, there are two tunnels in each of these documents. So to get the on-prem outside IP, under tunnel interface configuration, look for outside IP addresses, and then for customer gateway, just copy down this IP address. This is the external IP address for the on-prem router 1. And then just paste that into that line. And remember, this is for tunnel 1. You're also going to need the AWS outside IP address, and that's the line directly below it that's next to virtual private gateway. And again, this is under the outside IP addresses, under tunnel interface configuration, for IPsec Tunnel 1, so make sure you're in the right part of the file. Next, we'll need the on-premises inside IP for Connection 1 Tunnel 1. So straight below this, inside IP addresses, just copy down this entire IP address, including the slash 30, paste that in. Directly below that is the inside IP address for the AWS side. Copy that into your clipboard, paste that in, and then just scroll down slightly, and for the Connection 1 Tunnel 1 AWS BGP IP address, you're looking for the neighbor IP address in the BGP configuration options. So just copy that IP address into your clipboard, and just as verification, it should be the same IP address as the line above, only without the slash 30. We'll need to do that same process for Connection 1 Tunnel 2. So just scroll down in this document, locate IPsec Tunnel 2, Internet Key Exchange Information, and then you're looking for pre-shared key. So copy the entire string, making sure not to miss any of the characters into your clipboard, and then paste that in for Connection 1 Tunnel 2 pre-shared key. And we need to follow the same process to get those other IP addresses. So just scroll down in the document, look for Tunnel Interface Configuration, and then outside IP addresses first, copy the Customer Gateway IP address, and then paste that in, and this is also the public IP address for the on-premises router 1. Remember, both of these tunnels for Connection 1 are going to the same customer gateway. Directly below that, next to Virtual Private Gateway, is the AWS outside IP address for Connection 1 Tunnel 2. And note, this is different for the Connection 1 Tunnel 1 AWS outside IP address, because these are different endpoints. Scroll down a little bit more. For inside IP addresses, just copy down the customer gateway IP address. That's the on-premises inside IP. Paste that in, including the slash 30. The line directly below it is the AWS inside IP address. So copy that into your clipboard, paste that in, and then again, just scroll down a little bit further and get the neighbor IP address inside BGP configuration options. And just as with before, that should be the same IP address as the one directly above it, only without the slash 30. Now at this point, that's all of the information for Connection 1, which goes between AWS and the on-premises router 1. Now we need to open the equivalent document for Connection 2. So now I've opened Connection 2 config.txt. So this is the document for Connection 2. And I need to follow the same process. So there are two different tunnels as part of this VPN connection. First, I'm looking for IPsec Tunnel 1, which is at the top of this document. The first value that I need is the pre-shared key. So copy all of that into your clipboard. That's under Internet Key Exchange Configuration under IPsec Tunnel 1. And then scroll down, and under Tunnel Interface Configuration, first the outside IP addresses. So copy down the one for the customer gateway, and this is the public IP address of the on-premises router 2. Paste that in. Directly below that, next to virtual private gateway, is the outside IP address for endpoint 1 of this connection. So paste that in. And then scrolling down, we need the inside IP addresses of tunnel 1 for connection 2. So first, copy down the customer gateway, including the slash 30. Paste that in. Directly below it is the AWS side inside IP address. Copy that down, paste it in below. Scroll down just a little bit further, and then under BGP configuration options, get the neighbor IP address. That should be the same as the IP directly above, only without the slash 30. And then finally, we need to get the information for tunnel 2 of connection 2. So scroll down in the document. Under Internet Key Exchange Configuration, we need to get the pre-shared key. Again, make sure you do get the entire key, because there's often an underscore character at the very start. Make sure you select the entire thing from beginning to end. Paste that in, scroll down, locate Tunnel Interface Configuration, and then again we need these IP addresses. So first, outside IP addresses for the customer gateway. copy and then paste that into the template. Directly below it, next to virtual private gateway, we need to copy this IP address. And this is the AWS outside IP address for tunnel 2. Paste that in. Now we're on to the inside IP addresses. So first get the customer inside IP. Again, make sure you get the /30. Paste that in. Directly below it is the AWS inside IP address for this tunnel. Copy that, paste it in. And then finally, just scroll down under BGP configuration options and get the neighbor IP address. Copy that and paste that in. So that's all of the important configuration information from both of the connection configuration documents that you downloaded in the previous video. And we've extracted that now into this template, which will mean that we've got all of the information that we need to configure the IPsec tunnels at the on-premises side. So just as a summary as to where we are, we've configured the AWS side of the VPN configuration. We've allocated endpoints that the on-premises side can connect to, and we've downloaded the configuration information for those endpoints. In the next stage of the demo series, we're going to use all of this information that we've extracted to configure the StrongSwan IPsec VPN system that's running on the Ubuntu on-premises routers. So that's what we're going to do in the next stage of this demo series. At this point, though, you've done everything that you need to, so go ahead, complete this video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next stage of this demo series.